Potential candidates to head the National Security Council. They are retired Lieutenant General Keith Kellogg, former U.S. Ambassador to the U.N. John Bolton, and Lieutenant General H.R. McMaster. This comes after the president fired Michael Flynn. Trump will also be back to his campaign roots today. He's holding a rally in just a few hours in Melbourne, Florida. CNN's Washington correspondent Ryan Nobles is joining me live right now. So, Ryan, what do we know about these potential candidates?
Well, Virginia, for one thing, we know that the president wants to get this right after what happened with Michael Flynn, who was removed from this position so early on in the Trump presidency, that the president is really taking care to make sure that his replacement is someone that can stay in the job for some time. So let's go through these three candidates that are going to be at Mar-a-Lago this weekend. Among them, you have Keith Kellogg, who's currently the acting NSA advisor right now. He is someone who is well thought of within the White House. The staffers there appreciate him. He would like to stay on in the job, but it's clear that Trump is going to take a look at some other candidates, including McMaster. The general who you see here is someone who's also very well respected. He's got a PhD in military history from UNC Chapel Hill and has more than 30 years of military experience. But the front runner right now appears to be the former ambassador to the United Nations, John Bolton. Now, this is someone who did support the Iraq War, but he is someone that we are learning through political reporter Stephen Collinson is starting to grow with support within the White House. In fact, a number of NSC political staffers seem to support Bolton. So Donald Trump going to interview all three of these candidates this weekend, and the hope is from the administration that he makes a decision in the very near future. Frederica?
All right, Ryan Nobles, thanks so much. We'll check back with you. All right, I want to bring back now Kyron Skinner. She is a former member of Trump's national security team. Kyron, retired Army Lieutenant General Keith Kellogg, who was serving as the acting White House national security advisor. He told Associates that he would take the post permanently if President Donald Trump were to offer it. But given that he's the acting, why would it not mean that he's a shoo-in?
I think just what your the prior speaker said, I believe the president wants to get it right this time so that he doesn't face what Ronald Reagan faced during his 8 years as president, 6 national security advisors, basically one every 14 to 16 months. That's not productive for the White House or the National Security Council. So I think he wants to be deliberate and talk to a number of people. I know each person that's visiting Mar-a-Lago, and they're mavericks in their own right. They're fine statesmen. They've served their country with great distinction. I would not want to be in the president's shoes right now to make that decision, but I would support each one. And I think he's going to make a good choice this time. Not that Flynn was the wrong choice, but the National Security Council is a unique part of the national security structure of the U.S. And getting a person that understands that he's not a member of the cabinet, he or she, that it's a staff job in the White House, that done properly, it's really a back office think tank that produces the ideas, that facilitates the discussion among the Secretary of State, defense, and the other principals. It's hard to find a person who's willing to take that role and stay in that lane.
And then, Kyron, this just in, you know, according to senior administration officials, there is strong support among the NSC for John Bolton to be the national security advisor, given his knowledge of Washington and foreign policy. His supporters are also billing him as an outsider. So being an outsider, you would think, would help him in the case of Donald Trump, who has said, you know, he wants to take the non-traditional route.
He is a maverick in civil society, unlike the other two, McMaster and Kellogg. He is not a military man. He's had a distinguished career at State, Defense, USAID, the Justice Department, and the UN. So he's been in part of the scene in various dimensions for a long time. He's been on Fox News, really making the case about U.S. foreign policy and national security in a way that no one else has, and with a consistency in the last few years. He's really without peer in that way.